this right here has got to be like, oh, this right here has got to be like the secret to makeup. Like, I don't know, but every time I put this on, it just makes my makeup look like, I really think this is the reason why my makeup looks like so smooth. It literally like gets rid of your pores, so your skin will literally look like, so y'all, no, I'm so excited. I got this off of Amazon. Y'all, and I'm so excited to use it. Today is gonna be my first day using this brush set. So I'm going to go in with the spoolie now. It is brush 1. Y'all, this is brush 10. This ain't 1, this is brush 10. Wow. This is like 2 shades lighter than my skin tone. So I'm gonna go in with this up under my eyebrows. And you always wanna use a shade lighter up under your brows. So I'm gonna go in with the other end of this eyebrow tool from the Amazon green set, and we're gonna go over the top of the brow. All right, y'all, so I went ahead and used the same concealer that I used to clean up my brows underneath, and I put it on my eyelid. And the reason I did that is just cause concealer is a good source of makeup to use as a base when you're trying to do your eyelids. And it works for me. This is the Artistry palette, okay? This is the Artistry palette. And the color that I'm gonna go in with is this color right here. Y'all, because I don't know what I would do without this mascara, y'all. So I'm gonna show y'all a little trick. Y'all wanna know something? If y'all mess up and get mascara on a certain area, just go back in the same brush from whatever color, wherever the mascara is at. Like if it was on the pink, I would go back in the same with the same brush that I used for the pink eyeshadow. If it was on the brown area, I would go back in with the same brush that I used for the brown area and just blend it out, and it'll go away. What I'm going to go ahead and do now is go ahead and put my concealer for contouring on up under my eyes. I do not put foundation on up under my, right up under my eyelids. I don't do that. And I don't do it because I found that if I just put concealer up under it, it gives me a more lifted look. Then what I'm gonna do is go in with the second lightest color. Y'all know my favorite one to use is the the NYX Born to Glow Radiant Concealer. Y'all, when I tell y'all, this like gives me such a radiant look. Like, it just, I don't know, it just gives me a radiant look. So I love y'all. For the ones who don't, I sell lashes. And today I was stuck between Angel and Rich. Y'all know Carmen is the most popular, but I was stuck between Angel and Rich. And Angel is all me, of course. So that's why I was stuck between that, because it just looks so good to me. Those are 25 millimeter. But these are Rich, and these are the ones that I settle on. So now we're gonna do the concealer has set a little bit, so we're gonna blend it out. Okay, and now when it's all pressed in like that, we're gonna go in with our foundation now. So now we're gonna go in with our foundation. And like I said, I'm going to use brush two. And just gonna put it next to what we were doing. So I'm going with this brush. We're gonna take our dark stick. We're gonna go across right here. And this is going right on the cheekbone, y'all. Like right on the cheekbone. And I'm gonna go on my chin area with it. I know I like my concealer to sit a little bit before I start blending. So I'm gonna go right up under that with. Alright, so we're gonna blend this out. Practice makes what? Practice makes improvement. What I'm gonna do now is just go in and contour my nose a little bit. This stippling brush I've had for quite a while now. This is from Eco Tools, and you can really find this brush at like Target. But this brush is like a line eraser. It's like an eraser. Really, what you want to do with this powder is put it everywhere that you put concealer in. So what I'm doing here is just wiping the makeup off my lip. And today I'm just gonna wear lip gloss, y'all. This is ELF highlight brush, and I'm just gonna use this to take the powder off. What we're gonna do now is take our mascara, and we the same mascara, we're gonna go over this bottom line right here. We're gonna put on some powder now. The setting spray that I'm using is NYX Professional Makeup Radiant. Putting this bad little girl on. I just went in with the She Is Balm wax stick, and I just put that over the top of it. And so now what I'm gonna do is just take my hot comb, and we just gonna press this out. Mm-hmm. we're gonna go in with our Sebastian Shaper Spray. I'm just gonna spray the top of it. This is the finished look. I don't have no glue on my wig or anything like that because, like I told y'all today, I'm going for a really glueless look. So I do want to say that this is a 5x5 transparent lace wig. This is, like I said, our blonde and then straight, and it is raw Indian hair. This is not virgin hair. This is completely raw hair. Y'all know I only sell quality. This is not an HD lace, and you can see it blends really, really well. Like, I just want y'all to really look and see it blends really good. I love it. And the only thing I did was I put maybe one little small spray of this on the dead center of this lace so it can lay down. Other than that, I can really snatch this thing on right now and go. Like, you see? But I do want to go over this right here, y'all. I didn't get to use every single brush in this box right here. Just for the simple fact that I like my makeup to look a certain way. And if I were to use some of these brushes to replace like my contour brushes or my highlighter brushes, it was not going to look right. Because the simple fact that this does not have a contour brush in it. Don't think it has a highlighting brush in here either. It doesn't. They don't have a contour brush in this pack or a highlighting brush. I would give that brush set maybe like a I'll give it an 8 out of 10 just because that foundation brush, y'all, I think that foundation brush was better than mine. Like, that foundation brush is better than mine. The foundation brush that I have, I think it's from e.l.f. Yeah, it's an e.l.f. foundation brush. This one, like, it went on. Like, it went on my skin like butter. Like, it literally went on my skin like butter. So, that brush alone gets a 10 out of 10 for me. Like, it's a 10 out of 10. I'm gonna use it every time, okay? But yeah. Overall, though, I would give this an 8 out of 10. This was my first time. Well, I used it. This is my first time using this spray, Sebastian spray, as getting ready to go on this particular wig here. The very first time I used it at all, fresh out of the packaging, was on a wig that I just made, and I give the spray a 10 out of 10. Like, this spray is nothing like this spray. This spray right here, this is what you need. Like, this is what you need. This right here is not gonna get the job done as far as like taming any flyaways, holding the wig in a certain shape, and it's lightweight too. It doesn't weigh the hair down on top of that, and I like that. It doesn't make your hair crunchy, if you know what I mean. Like, this hair is still very much, it's still very much soft, it's still very much moving, but you don't see no flyaways. The flyaways aren't there. So this spray is a 10 out of 10. People were raving about it on TikTok and Instagram, and you just know your girl had to try it. So I tried it, and I give it a 10 out of 10. I need to buy me another can. It is on the pricey side, though. I think I paid like $30 for this can off of Amazon. But y'all, it's worth it. Go get it and stop playing. If y'all like this video, y'all already know what to do. Y'all, please give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment if there's anything y'all want to see me touch on in the next video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. All right, y'all. We out.